wanted to be. Let's get resituated here. Okay, so this was supposed to be Kingdom Hearts 2.8, Final Chapter Prologue, Birth by Sleep 0.2, Fragmentary Passage. But I'm kind of pissed off now. So we're going to rip on Square for a minute. Okay, first off, they have the gall and the right to think that they have the authority to add sharing restrictions down here. Okay, the game's a copyrighted work and a collaboration of authors from Disney. Yes. Characters rest the copyrights held by Square Enix. Yes. Okay. No, if I pay for your product, streaming is permitted in however I damn well please. Because I'm providing you free advertisement so that other people go out and buy your games. Obviously, though, if they're this crappily put together, probably better off watching a stream. Okay, if you want more information on the rights, go to that website. The phone number to contact Square Enix Customer Service is on my Twitch page. If you feel that I violated their copyright and need to report me, because... God. Okay. A 1 GB day one patch. Okay, that's not too bad in comparison to things, but it should have been more solid than that. You knew this was coming out. Second thing, over 10 gigabytes of hidden installation. That should have done that on the PlayStation dashboard. Because all opening the game up when I think it's ready to go and then trying to play it does is piss me off. Alright? I'm not a great programmer, but I can already... You know, I could have set it up better than that. Alright, so I can hear everybody in the headset. I got my drink behind me. I have to be sitting in my computer chair here because otherwise I am too far away for these new headphones to reach. I could use the old ones, but those I'm technically borrowing from a friend, and I believe I returned them, and if I didn't, I need to. So we're in the chair for now. We're gonna get this started. Wanted to put the whole title in the page, but PS4 didn't want me to do that. I didn't get cut off on my phone, so if I had entered it in my computer ahead of time, it would have worked. And I just didn't want to put up with the phone keyboard again to type in Kingdom Hearts 2.8, Final Chapter Prologue, Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep. Or Kingdom Hearts 0.2, Birth by Sleep, A Fragmentary Passage. Is that Unreal 4? Well, okay, then they've got less excuses for this to be glitchy, because a lot of the work's done for you. Nothing wrong with using a game engine. It makes a lot of great games, I'm just saying. I'll be a hell of a lot less forgiving between the installation and the fact that it's running Unreal 4 and not a custom engine. Because Kingdom Hearts 3 was supposed to be running the same engine as Final Fantasy 13 Versus, which became Final Fantasy 15. And a lot of engine testing for that was done with Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance. So this Unreal 4 thing has me a little bit worried. Let me move over here a bit. If I was thinking, I would have worn my Kingdom Hearts shirt today, but with as many problems as I had getting this going, kind of glad I didn't. Next week. It's a Birth by Sleep shirt, too. Okay. It is recommended to adjust the brightness until the right heart is slightly visible and the left heart disappears. Okay. I've already got that. Don't know if it looks the same to people watching, but there we go. Brightness can be adjusted to the config. Yeah, I would hope so. Pretty. I mean, I'm still gonna like this game, but I'm, you know, fair warning, I'm going in salty, which I'd rather not do. And even if I wasn't streaming this, I'd been pretty pissed off.
Woo!
Fly, letters, fly. We really put the whole thing up there. Alright. Now, the times I've said it and typed it, I only scrambled it up once just now, so... Yay! Some more underwater stuff. Oh my god, are we actually getting a new song? Okay, that's awesome. Drawing parallels back to the original, so. I mean, I'm fine with this. I don't mind a new remix. A new remix of the song they already used for a S5 game is fine. It's just a lot of the side games, like, use same song. And I love, Simple and Clean. Love Sanctuary. Just, you know, love to hear more Rattata music in other games than just two songs. Whoa! Okay, I played all of Birth by Sleep, and I don't remember this fight. Must have been from, Yeah, I remember fighting one of them, not both of them. I mean, I fought, you know, fought one at one time, one at the other time. I don't remember taking them both on as often. Maybe it's in the final mix? I haven't gotten around to that one yet. Ventus having that much green. I mean, it makes sense with how Final Fantasy does magic. It's cool. But Ventus basically looked like Roxas. Ooh, the bubble shields. Oh, there's a hand. I wonder whose glove that is. Yes. Okay, do I need to push a button? Try that. Yeah, it looks like I need... I was expecting the typical white splash screen with hand-drawn art. Oh, well, it's same menu structure, but yeah... Reason 3D this time. There's the castle back there. Awesome. I'm assuming it's Castle Oblivion. Whatever. She turned their home world into that, basically. Alright. Just gonna check the config real quick. Make sure there's nothing I need to mess with. Tilt up to look up and tilt it down to look down. Yes. Yeah, I mean, I guess if you want a hard mode, it's there. Yeah, just in case. Yeah, vibration's on by default, I want to leave it on. Brightness, fine. Ah, so you don't have to do it through a skill anymore. I never really understood that, why that was a hardcore way of playing Kingdom Hearts, but hey, some people like it, it's there, it's great. Always good to have replayability options. I love what we did with this song here. Bit different, but, you know, still the same. Alright. I don't ever play a Kingdom Hearts game on Proud Mode or higher unless I've beaten it before. I tried playing Final Mix 2, the Japanese version, on Critical. Regretted it. I tried playing Kingdom Hearts Final Mix on Proud Mode, and I picked Magic and got rid of the shield. Regretted it. Uh-oh. Options, oh, okay, well, I mean, I'd rather controls pop up in a more traditional tutorial, but okay, fine. Okay, so we can change camera angles with the pad. That's going to be weird. Move the character, rotate the camera. Okay. Show. Toggle lock on. Shot lock. Hold the button. Switch targets. Okay, so that's pretty typical. Okay, so only L1 will move my menu up and down, apparently. Or no, toggle. Okay, shortcuts. Like the old, like original Kingdom Hearts. God, maybe Kingdom Hearts 2 had them. I don't remember. Mini system, and that was a bit more forgiving, so I didn't use the shortcuts as much. Or at least don't recall using them. Okay. Alright. Situational command. Got it. Jump. Got it. Alright. Block. Dodge while moving. Alright. Okay. So, okay. Yeah, it's pretty much the same, other than L2 does nothing. Don't know why. We didn't put, like, toggle... I don't know. Why we didn't put something else up there. Like, shot lock, hold button. Why didn't we put shot lock on the other button? I don't know. We'll see. Block counter. Reset bind character. I don't know what. Why is it saying block counter down there? I don't know. And this is the first time I've played a new game on stream, so I hope nobody ruins it for me. Cause please don't. I want to, you know, share this with y'all. I figure this is a good time to take a break from Kingdom Hearts 1 for a bit. That looks cool. Oh, somebody in a robe with an evil-looking keyblade. Somebody in the reflection down there. And yeah, it's the Keyblade Graveyard. It looks a hell of a lot darker than it did at the end of Kingdom Hearts 2 or in Birth by Sleep.
The great battle with Xehanort is almost upon us.
Woohoo!
As you know,
oh!
We must take action to keep the seven pure lights safe. And thus we must hasten to assemble the seven guardians of light.
I count three.
It is time to return to our world, the three Keyblade wielders we lost over a decade ago. Ventus, Terra, and Aqua must be saved from their sad end, for they have more to achieve.
I'm pretty sure Terra's fucked.
Following their first battle with Xehanort, Ventus's heart refused to awaken, and so Aqua found a safe location to conceal him. But when she set off in search of her other missing friend, Terra, she fell to a place from which there is no return without outside help.
Oh, well, all right.
I saw her in the realm of darkness.
Oh, my. You saw her. Well, at least you already know who they're looking for here, because Riku and Kairi got no background information. Alright. This run on purpose at the beginning because I thought, oh, if they're running it here, they're not going to do what they did in Kingdom Hearts 1. Okay. Like, I love that remix. I'm going to figure out what it's called and I'm going to get my hands on it. It's like, oh, you know, don't stream this to listen to the music. It's like, I don't have to stream this for people to listen to the music. Because you have no sound test in here. All I have to do. Let's go download it online. Oh.
Could it be?
It's been a while since I've played Birth by Sleep. I'm just... so... Aqua's voice isn't exactly fresh in my mind. I hope it's the same woman. Dark World. Yeah, Willa Holland played her originally, and she did a really good job, and I love watching her in Eero. Then why did you have me read the controls? Yes, I'd like to view the tutorial just to make sure. Dim Kingdom Hearts shoes. Alright. And attack, magic items. This all looks really good. Okay. I guess I already have a high jump. Yep. Yes, I do. I didn't expect me to do that, apparently. Alright, well, let's try this. Okay, so that's about how high she can jump. Yeah, this looks like the same outfit she was in Brick My Sleep. There's just more detail to it, I guess.
Why is Cinderella's world here in the darkness?
Sounds like her to me. Ho-hoo! I don't remember this keyblade. Let's do it! Block and dodge you. Probably do more dodging than blocking. Counterattack me. Oh, she already has round block. I loved that about Aqua. Makes blocking a bit more practical for me. Press X to. Okay.
Yeah, hey, yeah, hey, farewell.
Awesome.
Hey, press, hi, hey, enough.
Just did that.
Yes, right. Hey, ha, hey, farewell. Yep. Hi, rest, hey. Hi, yep, ha, hey. Enough. Hey, hey.
I was just trying to block, just to make sure that, you know...
There's no time in the realm of darkness. I walk on and on without end.
Yeah.
In
if
the
they...
realm of light, yeah. Do days or years pass with each step? I know something has started to go wrong. I must hurry.
I'd use inner monologue, but I'll figure it out. If they recast, if they got someone that sounds very similar. I mean, even her hair moves. It's nuts. Normally, you know, they got that spiky anime protagonist hair that just does nothing.
I guess I know which way I'm going.
Sometimes a dead end isn't so dead. Ha ha! Drag's pulling every corner of the map. What? He said to explore, I mean... Don't got a map. Wardrobe? Okay, so tell me everything that happened in Birth by Sleep, and then there's stuff down there. I wanted to see what Keyblade I was using. Oh well. It's cool looking, that's what matters. So if it's sparkly, we can just sort of jump to it. Whoa. Let's see, approach, situation command, like open in the treasure chest. Yep. Yeah. I got more satisfaction of those things in previous games where I'm like pressing triangle to do all that. I mean, it was still pretty cool, especially that ice bit at the end, so. Use items in your inventory, select items you can use. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I don't need the potion, so there we go. And nothing on shortcuts, so. I mean, yeah, a lot of worlds got pulled into darkness by the Kingdom Hearts 1 rolled around.
I haven't felt
so.
My heart stir in a long time. Something about this place. It looks like worse things are stirring.
Alright, may have made a slight spill here, so I'm gonna have to deal with that.
Enough.
Woohoo!
51?
Farewell.
That explains the size of the HP gauge. Castle Dreams. Okay, one moment, folks. I want to make sure I didn't make a mess. Sorry about that. Okay, that wasn't so bad. Maybe spilled a sip was worth. But yeah, new plan. Coaster on the floor. I mean, I don't remember much of a village layout in Cinderella. These houses look really cool. I mean, obviously they had some houses and stuff in the movie. Menu help to read music controls. Okay, then that means that should be the end of tutorial. That was cool, Loka. Alright. You got a trophy for walking forward and smacking some shadows. Woohoo! Nice.
I took it for granted.
Yeah.
I thought I had nothing in life to lose.
Aww. Don't want Aqua to be the sad one. Yeah, you looked way more green in that opening cutscene. Sorry, folks, I'm still technically on the clock at work. I'm on call. I don't recognize that number, so unless they leave a voicemail. Stick that behind me there. You know, all those great birth by sleep moments.
Everyone in this world thought that they were safe.
Aww.
Not just the people. But the dog waiting for his owner. The cat curled up in her nook. So much life. Trees and flowers. There's no deeper sadness than discovering all that you knew was gone. The grief in this place is too much to fathom. That's enough. I can't keep on wishing for the past.
Yeah! All right. Okay, so fulfill specific conditions to complete objectives, and you're rewarded with clothing and accessories for Aqua's... Okay. Wardrobe. View conditions and rewards for various objectives in the main menu. Alright, I defeat the shadows up there. Test of strength, master of counters. Ooh, some of these we may just be reloading and doing off-stream. We'll see. No reason not to go for objectives. Figaro. So, if you ever wanted to be a cat chick, apparently it is kill shadows. Okay, so she gets a pauldron from her armor if you get her up to 60. Cat ears if you kill a bunch of shadows. Let's see what else is here. Wings. If you make counterattacks, we'll see. It's round block, so it's a bit more forgiving than your typical Kingdom Hearts guarding, so. Hit street lamps. Alright, we can do that. Oh, I guess it's a different kind of wings. I don't know. Climb to the highest point possible in Castletown. Find a meteor shower to get arm guards. Yeah, no reason to not see what's there. Alright. Okay, so pattern's the color, I guess. Huh, okay, so pattern and color kind of go hand in hand. Alright. Alright, cool. So I guess we're just stuck with the default Keyblade, which is fine. I like collecting Keyblades. This is a smaller game. So. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Oh, the clock's right at midnight. And now time's just out of control, okay! Jump, Aqua! Woo!
The rogue collapsed when the clock advanced. If only I made it in time. But there's no time in this place, only the clock.
It's gotta be Willa Holland. Inflections of that. Okay, so I have smashed gears. Oh, alright, I got a little bit of road back.
Knew it.
Okay, so I need to go find gears. Select magic, followed by the spell you wish to cast. Casting spells depletes MP. You cannot cast spells without MP. Okay, it's that straight MP gauge within the segment, so I'm assuming it just recharges. I really liked how they were doing it in a lot of the side games, where it's just the command was on cooldown. MP charge. This action restores your MP gauge after a certain amount of time. When you run out, it charges, comes back. Yep, so it's Kingdom Hearts 2 magic system. Which is unfortunate, because that pretty much sends me into a mentality where I'm going to use this to heal and absolutely nothing else. Especially if cure takes up a full gauge. Anything else besides shortcuts for easier access? Press options for switch commands. One set. One. Access for
I should look for gear.
That was what I was gonna do. Alright, so. Customize. Okay, so yeah, that is what. Okay, we have exactly what they showed us. Okay, we have max level fire, max level ice, max level thunder, and max level cure. MP cost 8, 12, 12, all. Alright, so yeah, I mean, yeah, just messing around Kingdom Hearts 2 a bit. It's like, yeah, you can cast the other spells till your magic gets low, but after that, you pretty much have to leave it until you need to heal. But I really hated that system. Kingdom Hearts 1 wasn't great, but a lot of what hurt Kingdom Hearts 2 magic is a lot of the spells changed how they worked. Fire became next to worthless, and ice basically behaved like fire. Save station. Yep. Okay, cool.
Farewell.
Okay, so that new objective has been unlocked, so maybe hitting the same street lamp over and over again counts. Ice there, but it hit. Oh, that's cool. Alright. If the spells work better, then that'll help.
Is that one on the bridge?
I will take your word for it.
That might be a gear up on that roof.
Alright, so we got a bridge and a roof to investigate. Alright, no reason not to save again real fast. Weird that they start you at level 50. Maybe Proud sets that level lower? I don't know. Oh, new objective has been added. Okay, so let's... Alright, well, yeah, we'll use our magic a bit. That way we can get credit for a... use ice magic to make a rail, then ride the rail? Holy crap. Freeze and shatter 5 heartless. Alright, so we certain types. Use the right type to hit an enemy for extra damage. Oh, I did that! Because, yeah, they were shooting fire, so I shot ice. Sorry about that, guys, but I have to leave the notifications on my phone in case, What? Been hitting all of them! Well, let's see what we got here. Arms? Cool.
Enough.
And that at least increased our count to 2. I know I'm kind of fixating on these street lamps here, but come on. Okay, so yeah, I guess the ones earlier just didn't count. Which is, unfortunate. Okay, I actually saw the one on the roof she was talking about, so... Let's see what we can do about that. I'm just thinking of Star Wars droid works. Yeah, I don't know if I need to actually hit the lamp part, which, I mean, kind of silly, really. Okay, so we can, we just need to jump towards the sparkles there, and then she'll do the rest. A little awkward, but easy enough.
Hey! Hey! You're done!
Okay, she only had to smack that other one once. Alright, presumably that'll gain us back another hour. Oh. Double flight lets you leap higher. Press blank mid jump to leap even higher. Oh, okay. New objective has been unlocked. Defeat Heartless while in midair. Okay, that's easy enough to do, I think. I don't want them all defeated in midair all at once. Okay, now you have to do the double flight before you do anything else, just making sure. Get any mid-air kills. Oh, I'm up to 15 street lamps. And probably went past the mid-air kills like a dummy. Alright, I guess it has to be all five at once. So, okay, never mind. That's going to be a hell of a lot more difficult.
enough!
Is that one on the bridge?
Hey!
Is that the bridge you're talking about? Yeah, okay, we can do that. Combo minus. If that thing wants to be hit by a finisher, then I want to get that done, you know, quickly. But yeah, there does appear to be AP type stuff, at least in this. But I'm sure this thing is basically a Kingdom Hearts 3 engine test. Shotlock. Alright. I think that's something that was in Dream Drop Distance. Alright, powerful attack, hits all target enemies, hold R1 to lock onto a bunch of people, and then fire with X. Oh, okay. Yeah, don't know why we couldn't have put that on L2. Focus gauge is depleted once the attack is unleashed, and it can't be used till the gauge is restored. Restore it by getting that type of orb. Oh, that makes shock lock a hell of a lot more boring. It's like, you know, oh, then I'm gonna be, it's like, what if there's a bigger enemy horde coming up? I don't know if I want to use that right now. Not for this. Yeah. Okay, so killing them got me back about half of my gauge.
Hey, enough!
Next time I have gauge and there's a lot of enemies, I'm gonna try using shot lock from midair. Maybe that'll do it? Oh, hey, look at that!
Enough!
Okay, that's back. Awesome.
Yep.
And I can do that as long as it looks like after a short cooldown, as long as I'm still in midair. So that'll help their kills. Hello, gentlemen. Awesome. How I got that. Must have accidentally done a challenge. That looks cool, though. Sorry, people. Oh. Yeah, I just wanted to be close to the design, but yeah, it's really cool that you can pretty much pick whatever you want. Must have been the so-called bat roof. You know, I'll look around a bit. Huh. Shows you how much reliance I have on waypoints. I'm not really big on exploration as far as games go. Know where I'm going and see if I can figure out how quickly I can get there. Let's go ahead and save it. I don't want to lose any progress. Oh. Does save points do focus gauge too? Yep, okay. Okay, so we know they're at Nitty over there. One hasn't spawned on the bridge since we've been rebuilding it. Did I just get a trophy for walking around? And it had Explorer in the title, right after I said I don't really like exploration.
I doubt that I'll find anything else here.
Alright, alright. Aha! Here's something, maybe.
There's an underground path. Interesting.
Very interesting. Okay, I'm just making sure that if I... Okay, yeah, we found it. So yeah, I didn't want to jump down here and then it'd be somewhere I already have been before.
You're done.
Carry over this coloration, the colorization thing, maybe give you like a few areas that can be colored different colors, you know? Then maybe let you unlock some presets in case you don't want to fiddle with it. Situation command spear during battle. Okay. They appear depending on your battle style. Huh. That to activate them. And select the command. I mean, I don't really get what the numbers are next to it. I guess we got another page. Some situation commands let you transform your battle style with a style change or allow you to unleash powerful spells. Oh, well, I liked the style change thing from, Birth by Sleep. That was a cheap building up combo, I believe.
Hey! 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 Enough!
Cool. yeah, they took what they learned from the side games and, you know, previous main installments. Came up with something I think's pretty good. Oh, that has a soul. Okay. Alright, that should be all the gears, so...
Yep!
I keep thinking I can glide. Well, I guess I kind of can.
Yep!
Wait a minute. That could be awesome, man. Saving it would probably be an intelligent idea. Ho! Okay! I'm low on health. I do not want to go into Spell Weaver. Looks like enemies don't have to be killed with finishing attacks or magic anymore, so I just smacked them and they went down. That was nuts. I mean, yeah, it's still, you know, pretty typical Kingdom Hearts type fight. Oh, well that's something you need to fix. If I can customize what's equipped to me, the cutscene should probably reflect that.
They're safe from the darkness.
Oh. I don't want her to be the broody one when she gets out of here. Come on. I mean, I know Ventus was the happy-go-lucky one, but she wasn't this
what
sad.
What I wouldn't give to really turn back time. To spend one more night beneath the stars with my best friends. I'm doing it again.
Aqua.
God.
It can't be. What are you doing here?
That
ain't
true.
You should be in the Realm of Light. Oh no. Did you not make it out? Don't tell me. Has the Realm of Light... Why won't you say anything to me?
Well, he said your name.
Uh, So what are you? A memory among these shadows? Are you here to try and tell me not to lose heart?
Okay.
The world keeps our thoughts alive. But where do the people who lived here go once the world was taken away? At least they're not here, so they haven't fallen to darkness. I'll take what solace I can from that.
Huh, see, I figured they'd be here, but they don't really go over what happens to fallen worlds, other than, oh, some people escape.
Another world that was lost to the darkness.
And some people turn into summons. Hmm?
Is that...
I can't tell him this.
Ven!
That's weird. So yeah, you left him in the magic palace room.
Ven, what did you come here to tell me? I know I promised to wake you up. I'm sorry. But I have to find a way home before I can help you. I just want you to know that it's been you that keeps my heart strong, keeps the dark away.
It is the magic mirror, which you fought in Birth by Sleep.
It's a mirror.
Y'all wouldn't have recommended doing that. Of course, I don't remember if she was the one that fought the mirror, so she may not have known. Okay, so Aqua has pulled Aqua into the mirror, so am I fighting Aqua? Weird symbols around the mirror, animals... I mean, is this supposed to be the Queen's Palace from Snow White? Because it's been a while since I played Birth by Sleep. There's not too many scenes in the palace. Oh god. Those mirrors want me dead.
What just happened? Those mirrors. Maybe they're a clue.
Well, gang, it's like we have another mystery on our hands. Alright. I was wanting to go a little longer than an hour today, but with the game taking, had to get started a little later today than I wanted to because of work, which, you know, need to get paid, so... Then I had to, patching the game didn't actually take all that long. I wanted to start about 3:15 because I was done with everything I needed to do by about 3. So I got that done, and then the game's like, yep, gotta install. Alright, so we'll save it. I actually didn't think I'd have selectable worlds, but multiple worlds fell to darkness, so... Makes sense. I've been staying pretty blind on this game. I heard about the Heartless Tower. And that's about it. And I knew about objectives.
Hey!
place is evil. Okay, so these little side... I mean, am I looking for specific mirrors? Because... Let's check this one. That one up last time, I'm pretty sure. So let's try this one, maybe. Honestly, I'm just trying to figure out what these things do before I quit. Okay, so they do open up locations. This is like the mine from Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. So we already saved it back there, so I know what one I'm going to try hitting up next time, because this is a really cool-looking area. But, yeah, unfortunately, I can only go about 15 more minutes, and I didn't really want to push it that far with being as good of a stopping point as we are. So, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. If you liked what you've been seeing today, be sure to click the little purple follow heart in the bottom left-hand corner of the video. That'll let you know when Hawk was trying to break out of the Dark World again. If you want to have a bit of notice when the streams are coming up, you can go to the Dr.Sun Facebook page or the Dr.Sun is in Steam group. If you want to see back streams like today's adventure, you can go to the Dr.Sun is in YouTube channel. And barring any technical difficulties or copyright issues, they'll be there. Also, I'm currently using Tumblr as sort of a stand-in for a website until I can figure out a better solution. And also, it's, you know, free, so yay. And that's at drsunisin.tumblr.com. That's dr-sun-is-in.tumblr.com. So I write fiction and fan fiction over there, and I'm still considering adding video game review-type content, but... Between my health, I'd rather just try to keep a consistent streaming schedule right now. So, I believe that's everything, so... Until next time, I'm Dr. Sun. I keep on playing those games in the Land of the Rising Sun. Good night, everybody.